This year, Halloween fell on a weekend. Me and Ghetto Boys are trick-or-treating.
What's good, people? Welcome to the Uptown Horror Review Show. Today we are going to be reviewing Fantasticland by Mike Bockoven. I hope you like this video, I hope you leave a comment, and if you haven't already, please subscribe to my motherfucking channel. Let's just get right into it. Alright, so this book takes place in this giant amusement park called Fantasticland. This park is world renowned, you know, people travel here from all different countries every year, you know, this park is a huge success, but it is all about to go to hell. There are reports of this mega hurricane that is unlike anything meteorologists have ever seen before, and this storm is making a fucking beeline directly to this amusement park, right? So everyone in the immediate area are fucking panicking now. You know, people are taking flights out of state just to try to escape this hurricane. People are leaving all of their earthly possessions behind just so they won't get caught in this storm. But upper management at Fantasticland is like, nah, we need some people to stay behind and watch over the park. And, you know, we just need them to show their faces and ward off anyone who might want to come and start looting. So, yo, they get 300 of the park's youngest employees and they stick them in this underground fallout shelter beneath the park. And they like, yo, just stay down here. Wait for the hurricane to blow over, and you know, once it is safe to go back outside, y'all are all gonna go out and watch over the park for a few days, and before you know it, you are all gonna be able to go back home, and you are all gonna have a fat paycheck. So yo, the storm has finally arrived, and you know, everyone is in this underground fallout shelter, and you know, they getting along for the most part, you know, they playing cards, and they playing fucking dominoes and shit. But out of nowhere, all of the lights go out, and that is the first sign that things are about to go terribly fucking wrong for these people. It turns out that there was a temporary power outage, and yo, the second the lights go out, all fucking hell breaks loose. People are trampling over each other, trying to find some type of light source. People are fucking pushing people out the way. And in all this chaos, three kids wind up getting trampled and killed in the process. And that event alone, it flipped the switch in everyone's mind. And now all of the people who are in charge of these kids, they have lost all authority and all control that they had. And to these kids, it is every man for himself, right? So a couple of days go by, and you know, the time has come for them to finally go back outside. And yo, once they take one look outside, they realize that this storm was way worse than anything they ever could have imagined, and ain't nobody coming to save them anytime soon. So for some reason, I can't even tell you why they do this, but yo, they all collectively just say fuck it, and they all start killing each other, man. They start forming little gangs. And before you know it, this family-friendly theme park has turned into a war zone, right? And as if that wasn't bad enough, these two masked individuals show up at the park, and they just start picking people off one by one, man. Nobody knows who they are, nobody knows where the fuck these people came from. But if you get caught slipping and you are outside by yourself at nighttime, these two psychopaths will hunt you down like a wild animal, and you will never be seen again. So while all of this BS is happening, there's this one kid who, you know, as soon as all of the violence commences, yo, he sees all of this nonsense happening, and he's like, yo, I'm getting the fuck up out of here. I refuse to take part in this. So he goes to one of the nearby hotels that are connected to the park, and yo, he has this entire 20-story, 5-star hotel to himself. And while all of these fucking dumb motherfuckers are killing each other and going to war with each other, he's over here having the time of his life. So he's over here without a care in the world, you know, not worrying about a damn thing. And before you know it, those two fucking psychopaths show up, and from the second he first lays eyes on them, he already knows they have nothing good planned for him. So for the entire chapter, we follow this kid as he gets hunted down by these two psychopaths for like a good 2 weeks. And yo, for every second of every day, he is playing the deadliest game of hide and seek with these people, and it was fucking amazing. Now, if I'm being honest with you, you know, I wasn't really too crazy about this book as a whole, and you know, I'm not gonna spoil what happens in the story, But yo, all I'm gonna say is that this one chapter, this hotel chapter, and these two psychopaths roaming the park, this was the book's saving grace, man. If it weren't for those two things, I probably wouldn't even have finished this fucking book, man. Because the whole plot of these kids killing each other, it just made no sense. It made no sense at all. These people had more than enough food and water to go around. You know, they had adequate clothing and shelter. Them killing each other served no purpose whatsoever. You got what I'm saying? Now, the author tries to say that, you know, all of this violence is going on because these kids just can't handle being without social media for a prolonged amount of time. But you tell me, man, if you were forced to be without your phone and to be without social media for a few weeks, would you just get up and start killing people? You get what I'm saying? It may sound like I'm ranting right now, but yo, the book has so much potential, and the book would have been so fucking great if the killing just made sense. You get what I'm saying? But yeah, man, if I had to give this book a score, you know, I know a lot of people love this book and a lot of people speak highly of this book, but if I personally had to give it a score, I would give it a 5 out of 10. And that's my review, man. Fantasticland by Mike Bockoven. I'm giving it a 5 out of 10. And with that, I'm out. I hope you like this video. I hope you leave a comment. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to my motherfucking channel. I'm out. They gon' drop it low, cause it's bands on the floor. Police try to ask me questions, I don't know. Everywhere I go, man, you know I keep a pole. 10 toes down, I can't really trust a soul. Can't trust no nigga, can't trust a bitch. Test, stay 10 toes down and never switch. Can't trust no nigga, can't trust a bitch. Test, stay 10 toes down and never switch.